In 2020, Robert Williams was arrested because an image recognition model fakely assumed that he was a criminal on the run. He was dehumanized and degraded for over 24 hours. Further analysis on the model showed that it said every single black man was a criminal on the run. The practitioners assumed that this unintelligible model was right without questioning it. For years, data has been increasing, and as a result, models are getting more and more complex. This means that instead of the simple linear regression we were once used to, we now have these huge neural networks that have millions of unintelligible weights. As a result, there have been post-hoc explainability methods that have been developed to try to explain what these models are doing. Specifically, my thesis is working on analyzing and evaluating those explainability methods. There's three main state-of-the-art explainability methods. First is LIME, which approximate these large neural networks with simple linear regression models. Second is SHAP, which uses game theory subjects and treats inputs like players in an explainability game. Third is VanillaGrad, which looks at nodes and looks at patterns and trends to try to explain how an input becomes an output. Now, if each of these explanation methods agreed, we would have no issue. But the first and most important result of my thesis is that these three disagree a lot. For instance, if we take a model that sets bail, one might say that the bail was set because of the race. One might say that the bail was set because the criminal was actually violent or dangerous. This makes it impossible to understand if the model is biased. So once we've established this disagreement problem, the seminal problem in explainable machine learning, we then begin the work of resolving that. And to resolve that, we come up with a list of desiderata, or properties that we think are desirable for explanations. For instance, stability. For the same input, the explanation should be the same for a model. Or fidelity. If we say that certain inputs are important, and then we set those inputs to be zero, the output of the model should change drastically. Once we were able to understand which properties were desirable, we were able to say, for this model, this explanation method is the best. For instance, for deep learning recommendation models that are used by Facebook, we say that LIME is the best. While for models that are graph neural networks to use to understand chemistry, we say that SHAP is the best. There's this common misconception that more human artificial intelligence is scary, that we'll get some doomsday situation like the Matrix. But in the short term, we should expect our artificial intelligence to become more human-like. Like a child who is only expected to do mental math tests in elementary school, once they graduate, we must expect both the answer and the explanation. Thank you.